Now let us have you meet and they meet you, our new players. As partner to Betsy Palmer, we have a gentleman from Chicago, Illinois, Andy Murphy, who's a salesman. Are you married, Andy?
No, I'm single.
You lucky fella. No, that'll change too, I'm sure. Bill Cullen's new partner is a pretty lady, Jill Borland from Buffalo, New York. I'll ask the same question. Are you married, Jill?
No, I'm not.
Jill, would you like to meet Andy Murphy over here? Good luck to both of you. Let's play the faces familiar, shall we? To start the game, we're going to show you one part of a very famous face. So light up the screen, please. That's just one of seven parts that make up the complete face. Now, in order to get a better idea of whose face it really is, we're going to add more parts to it every time you can complete my statement. Betsy Palmer and Bill Cullen will start for two parts of the familiar face. Complete this statement. A party for men only. Yes, Betsy.
Stag party.
How, you know? How would you know a thing like that, for heaven's sakes? It happens to be right. Betsy, you get a first chance to identify our famous personality. Look to the screen. See if you know him or her by looking at two parts of the familiar face.
Jonathan Winters.
You say that's Jonathan Winters? That is not Jonathan Winters. Andy Murphy, Jill Borland, first time for you now. Finger on the buttons. Complete this statement for three parts. Lil Abner and Daisy May live in the town. Yes, Andy.
Dog patch.
Dog patch is where they live. Very good. All right, look to the screen now. Andy, see if you know who our famous personality is by looking at three parts of his famous face. For the game and $200.
Perry Como.
You say that's Perry Como. That is not the face of Perry Como. Betsy and Bill for four parts. If you have more than one wife at the... Yes, Bill?
How would you know?
Bigamist.
And you made a boo-boo, too. But we'd accept either answer in that case. That's right. Look to the screen, Bill. See if you know who our famous star is by looking at four parts of his familiar face. For the game and $200, is that face familiar? Time beat you there, Bill. Okay, we go on now. Andy and Jill playing against each other for five parts. Complete this. To help speed your mail, you use a zip... Jill, code is what we were after, and you almost got too early there. All right, Jill, now see if you can make this identification and win the game. Is that face familiar when you see four parts of that famous star?
That really helps. Really doesn't. Jerry Lewis.
You say that's Jerry Lewis? That is not the face of Jerry Lewis. Back to Betsy and Bill now for six parts. Complete this, Bets and Bill. The slang term for a mystery novel, Bill.
How'd that work? Oh, the slang term for mystery novels, he wants to know.
Yes.
Mystery
tonight
novels.
Sometime.
Yeah. Who done it?
Who done it is what we were after. I thought you never were going to done it. All right, Bill. Now, on behalf of Jill Borland, look at the screen. See if you know who this famous star is when you see six parts of his famous face.
God is punishing you.
He looks like he's been in an accident. I am. I gotta say, in a...
Time beats you again, Bill. All right, to see all seven parts, Jill and Andy, fingers on the button. A very close horse race ends in a photo. Yes, Jill.
Finish
is what we're after now. Let's light up all seven parts of that very familiar face.
Oh, Glenn Ford.
You say Glenn Ford?
No. Yeah.
That is... Not the face of Glenn Ford. All right, now all seven parts of that face have been revealed without a correct identification. So now we're going to give you a chance to straighten out the face by switching any two parts of the picture, one with the other. It'll be Betsy against Bill, this time for a switch. Complete this statement. When you commit a social blunder, Yes, Betsy?
It's a faux pas.
That's what we were after, and you beat it. Very good for you.
All right.
Yeah, Fox Pass, yeah.
Okay, no,
Betsy
then.
And Andy get a chance to switch any two parts, one with the other. Betsy, which part will you switch?
All right, Andrew. Six and...
With what, Andy?
There's only one thing.
Six. Four.
That's...
Six with four.
Really?
You hope that will help you straighten out the face and make an identification. Let's see if it does now. We will switch four with six. And
ready to...
That's the widest mustache ever saw. in between you now for the game of $200. is that face any more familiar?
Andy thinks he knows.
Who Tony Martin.
Tony Martin.
Tony.
Incredible. Yep. That is not Tony Martin. Oh. For another switch now. Andy is still in this. Andy Murphy and Jill Boland now play for a switch. Complete this statement.
Come on, Andy.
In Ireland, it's considered good luck to kiss the... Yes, Andy.
Blarney Stone.
Blarney Stone, Mr. Murphy. Of course, you ought to know that. All right, now you and Betsy can switch again. Now, Andy, you pick the first one.
Pick the mustache.
One.
Going to switch one with what other part, Betsy?
I guess I have to go to four.
Okay, that's what we'll do. Let's see how that happens. We'll switch now number one with number four. Any one answer between you. Is that face familiar now?
Robert Ryan.
Robert, it is not Robert Ryan.
No.
All right, Bill and Betsy. Bill and Betsy for a switch. Complete this statement. If listen to this carefully. If you're dancing with your thumbs in your ears and wiggling your fingers, yes, Bill?
Thumbs in the frug.
No. You are doing the mouse is the correct answer. So for an incorrect answer, again, it goes to Betsy and Andy. Get a chance to switch. Betsy, which one will you switch this time?
Five.
You're going to switch five?
Come on now, Andy.
Five and three.
You're going to switch five and three this time. We're going to see what happens now if that face becomes familiar. Let's switch, if you will, number five with number three. One answer between. Switch, complete this statement. If you've had a bad dream, you've had a
nightmare
for a switch. Which one, Jill?
It's Jack Lemmon.
Without the switch, you're going to give up the switch? You want me to accept that answer? It's up to you. You better switch.
I think we should switch. Is that all
right, Jill?
I think we should switch.
All right, you make the switch. Pick one part of the switch.
I think I better do something. Four.
Four with what other part, Bill?
Four?
Six.
Four with... Okay. You asked for it, friends. We're going to switch number four with number six. One answer between you. He's got his mustache again.
That is
the face of Jack Lemmon. Bill just couldn't stand it without the mustache.
I'm not convinced. Let's switch it around a little more.
You did it. That's
Andy
worth fun.
Red button and everything.
$200 you've got for the identification, Jill. A chance at $500 more. The moment we're going to show you and Bill three of a kind. Three pairs of eyes, three noses, and three pairs of lips. Every correct identification is worth $50. Three in a row gets $500. We're going to start with you, Bill. We'll tell you in advance. We're looking now for the eyes of Andy Griffith. Look at the screen and tell us which pair of eyes belongs to Andy Griffith. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Here is number one.
Never get a girl.
Number two. Number three for $50.
Number one.
You say number one. Those are the ones you pick. We move them on the screen to where they belong.
Show it to me. Show it.
And those really are the eyes of Andy Griffith. Two for $50 now. We're looking for you to identify the nose of Betsy Palmer.
Uh-oh.
The nose of Betsy Palmer. Look at this. Look at the screen, Jill. Here is nose number one. And number two. And number three. Which nose belongs to our guest star tonight, Betsy Palmer?
Number two.
You say number two. That's the nose you picked for Betsy Palmer. We'll move it on the screen to where it belongs for a full face.
Oh,
and that really is the nose of Julie Andrews.
Number one, I
my best.
Well, you were number one, and you were in good company with Julie Andrews, too.
Yes,
Bill, you can make $50 for Jill Borland. Try to identify now the lips of Jack Benny.
Why don't I ever get a girl?
Look at the screen, Bill.
Sure,
and try to identify one of these pairs of lips. Here's number one, number two, and number three.
They're all delivered, Jack.
One, only one belongs to Jack Benny. Which one do you say?
Three.
You say number three. You have picked those lips to belong to Jack Benny. Let's move them on the screen where they would belong. Those are the lips of Bennett Cerf.
Jack, would you kindly ask the audience not to shout out the wrong answers?
Jack Benny was number one in that case, Bill. But Jill, you got $200 for the game, another $50. A total of $250 goes to you. Andy, you'll have a nice gift. Thank you so much for a lot of fun tonight on the Faces of Liberty. We'll be back in just a moment, right after this word from our sponsor. Well, that sums up our familiar faces on this program for tonight. I got to make room for the other familiar faces on CBS. Betsy, we had just a ball tonight. Thank you so much.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Wait till I slice up my face. It'll become familiar. Do come back soon.
Thanks for being on
our maiden voyage. And Bill, thanks to you, buddy.
My apologies to Jack Lemmon, but we did this poor fellow.
When he sees this, he'll probably grow a mustache. Thank you so much. Next week, our guest stars will be Edie Gourmet and Alan King. We hope you'll be along. Until then, the name is Jack Clark. I hope the face is familiar.
Jack.
The Face is Familiar is a Bob Stewart production.